हरे
राम
रामा
राम
रामा
राम
रामा
हरे
हरे
हरे,
हरे
हरे कृष्णा
कृष्ण
कृष्णा कृष्णा
कृष्णा
हरे
कृष्णा
हरे,
हरे हरे,
हरे
हरे रामा हरे
राम
रामा
राम
रामा
राम
रामा
हरे
हरे
हरे,
हरे
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 कृष्णा
कृष्ण
कृष्णा कृष्णा
कृष्ण
हरे
कृष्ण
हरे,
हरे
हरे
हरे हरे
राम
रामा हरे रामा
राम राम
राम
राम
राम
हरे
हरे हरे।
हरे। I'll share now the screen. Are you able to see my screen?
Yes, Mataji, we can see your screen.
Okay, thank you. Okay. Just repeat with me. ब्राह्मणा क्षत्रिय वैश्याम
ब्राह्मणा
क्षत्रिय
क्षत्रिय
वैश्याम
ब्राह्मणा क्षत्रिय वैश्याम
ब्राह्मणा
ब्राह्मणा
क्षत्रिय
क्षत्रिय
वैश्याम
शूद्राणां च परन्तप
शूद्राणां च
परन्तप
कर्माणि परिविक्तानि
कर्माणि परिविक्तानि
स्वभावा प्रभाविर्गुणः
स्वभाव
प्रभाविर्गुणः
ब्राह्मणा क्षत्रिय वैश्याम
ब्राह्मणा
क्षत्रिय
वैश्याम
शूद्राणां च परन्तप
शूद्राणां च परन्तप
कर्माणि परिविभक्तानि
कर्माणि
परिविभक्तानि
स्वभावा प्रभाविर्गुणः
स्वभाव प्रभाव गुणः ब्राह्मण क्षत्रिय वैश्याम
ब्राह्मण क्षत्रिय वैश्याम
शूद्राणां च परन्तप
शूद्राणां च परन्तप
कर्माणि प्रविभक्तानि
कर्माणि प्रविभक्तानि
स्वभाव प्रभवैर्गुणैः
स्वभाव
प्रभवैर्गुणैः
ब्राह्मण क्षत्रिय वैश्याम
ब्राह्मण क्षत्रिय वैश्याम
शूद्राणां च परन्तप
शूद्राणां च परन्तप
कर्माणि प्रविभक्तानि
कर्माणि प्रविभक्तानि
स्वभाव प्रभवैर्गुणः
स्वभाव
प्रभवैर्गुणः
ब्राह्मण क्षत्रिय वैश्याम
ब्राह्मण पवित्र
शूद्राणां च परन्तप
शूद्राणां च परन्तप
कर्माणि प्रविभक्तानि
कर्माणि प्रविभक्तानि
स्वभाव प्रभवैर्गुणैः
वैश्यास स्वभाव
स्वभाव देयर ओन
नेचर
प्रभवै बोर्न ऑफ
प्रभवै
बोर्न ऑफ गुणयः बाय द मोड्स ऑफ मटेरियल नेचर
गुणयः
द मोड्स ऑफ मटेरियल नेचर
ट्रांसलेशन पर शिला प्रभुपाद की जय ब्राह्मणा क्षत्रियस वैश्यस एंड शूद्रस आर डिस्टिंग्विश्ड बाय द क्वालिटीज बोर्न ऑफ देयर ओन नेचर्स इन अकॉर्डेंस विद द मटेरियल मोड्स ओ चैस्टाइजर ऑफ द एनिमी स्वयं रूप कदाम स्वापता वंदेहम श्रीगुरशत कमल श्रीगुरोन् वैष्णवांश श्रीरूपं शाकृष गुणातम तम श्रीवित सास्वैत सौदात परिजन श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य देवं श्रीराधा कृष्ण पादान संगललिता श्री विदाका विदांश हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीन बंधो जगत्पते कोपेश कोपिका कांधर अधराधा कांता नमस्तुते सप्त कांधन गौरांगी राधे वृंदानेश्वरी वृषभानु सुदे देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधरा श्री वासादि गुरु भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। I'll stop sharing and I'll discuss. Are you able to see my screen? Like you are able to see me?
Yeah, we can see you.
Yes, thank you, Mataji. He says like, Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, and Sudram, Cha Paranthapa, Karmani, Parivigatani, Swabhava, Prabhayir, Gunayaha. So what he says that is, Brahmana, Kshatriyas, Vaishyas, and Sudras are distinguished by the qualities born of their own natures in accordance with the material modes. O chastiser of the enemy. He calls here Arjuna as Parantapa. Oh, you want to call him as a Parantapa. Parantapa means who is a subduer of the enemy. Subduer of the enemy means who controls the enemies. That means here Krishna is indicating that and he like Arjuna was a Kshatriya. Like he is telling that now he is going to explain about the four classes of the Varnashramadama, the four classes of Varna. He is going to explain about it. So first he is just indicating that by calling Arjuna as a Parantapa. Parantapa is a subduer of enemy. Oh, Kshatriya, that you are in the class of a Kshatriya. But Arjuna was a pure devotee. Like he is a devotee of the God. And even though he is there in the class of a Kshatriya, he just surrendered to the Lord. Right? He was surrendered to the Lord. He accepted the orders of the Lord. But even though he just, Krishna is saying that even though if you are being the devotee of the Lord, you need to have to do your duty, your prescribed duty as a Kshatriya. For that he says that here as Parantapa. So you see that in Bhagavad Gita, in any slokas, that like whatever slokas when you take, like Lord will be calling Arjuna in different names, right? Like he will be calling as Kaunteya, Kudakesha and all that. So if you just observe everything, you know, like what Lord is going to explain to Arjuna, according to that, he will call his name. You see that, like for explaining to tolerance and all that, Lord will call him as Kaunteya. Why he is calling as Kaunteya, you know, like because he calls as Kaunteya is like your Kunti's son. So he says that how it is possible, like you become the son of Kunti, you are not able to have that ability of tolerance. So such ways, and Lord will like indirectly, he will just call the names of Arjuna based according to how he is giving the explanation to Arjuna. So here he is going to explain about the four classes, Varnashrama. Yesterday we have been discussing in it was in 18.40, like Ankur Prabhu was discussing about the three modes. He was summarizing about the three modes. So he says that this three modes is not only affecting this earthly planet, is affecting the heavenly and all the planets from Brahma to everyone. These three modes are being get affected. So how, like Lord was just summarizing about these three modes, and he just started going about through Varnashrama. So why he was just explaining about this Varnashrama is like, so for these three modes, the platform is the Varnashrama. So the people has to do some karma, right? Like everyone has to do some work. So I have to do some work, you have to do some work, but according to our modes, we are doing some work. Your Brahmana will be doing a work, and a Kshatriya is performing some work, and a Vaishya is performing a work, and Shudra is performing a work. So he says these four classes is already discussed by Lord in fourth chapter. Like even the fourth chapter, he says that Chaturvarna Mayatitam. He says that about the four classes of people, like the four classes of men, like he says that is a Kshatriya, like Vaishya and Sudra. What he says that is, according to the three modes of material nature and the work associated with the four divisions of human society are created by me. And although I am the creator of the system, you should know that I am yet the non-doer being unchangeable. So he's already discussed about that, like about what is that, about these four divisions of human society. Here, Prabhupada has not given any purport because this purport is already discussed in the fourth chapter. So he says about the four divisions. So what are the four divisions here describes is about the Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya and Sudras. I basically know like everyone will be knowing about these four classes, right? Like you might be knowing who is a Brahmana, who is a Kshatriya, who is a Vaishya and Sudra. These four classes of four classes of men is given this human society is to give peacefulness. That to give the peacefulness for the, like it has to give the peacefulness for the entire society, Krishna has given these four classes. So first is about the Brahmana. Like I will give you a very not a very brief description. I'll touch about this topic. Okay, that is about who is a Brahmana, who is a Kshatriya, who is a Vaishya and Sudra. Brahmana are considered to be is a high intelligent class. They are considered to be the high intelligent class who always be discussing about the about the spiritual realizations and about the philosophy. So they are considered to be as a Brahmanas. So they are always being in the top. It's in the first class. So in your body, when you segregate, the first part of our body is the head, right? So the Brahmana will be there in the part of the head. So where in the part of the head, you will be like, he just want to use his brain and his tongue. These are the both things the Brahmana will be always using. So when he was reciting the Vedas, when he was discussing about any topics related to spirituality, he want the tongue. So he has to speak to the tongue only. So for that, he have to recite Vedas, he have to recite slokas and everything. So for that, he needs more intelligence. So if you have more knowledge only, he's able to be discussed. So the Brahmana is the first class. And the second class is goes to be a Kshatriya. So what is about a Kshatriya? Kshat means who is going to be protected, the person who protect. Kshatriya is an administrative class. So in this administrative class, what they will do is like they will try to rule others. So that is the administrative classes that is called as a Kshatriya. But the Kshatriya is the next part, the second class. The second part of the body is about the arms, the shoulders. So they have to be very strong in, like it is a part of the shoulder, they are very strong. So they are considered to be in the second class. And then the third class is considered to be as Vaishyas. So what about the Vaishyas? Vaishyas are considered to be as a mercantile class. They are a business class. So they are the people who always do business. They are farming, cattle and all that, like farming and all that business. They are mostly on the mercantile business. So Vaishyas, they will, their most part is only the third class because their level of intelligence will decrease from the Brahmana to the Vaishyas. The level of intelligence will decrease. They don't want to worry about what they will be reciting in the Vedas and all that. So they will basically will do whatever occupation is like the normal occupation. Like they will do farming, they will take care of the cows, they will protect the cows and all that. So what they will be mostly thinking about like how to earn money and how to develop that economical development for that earth, for that wealth, for that only they will work more. So that is Vaishyas. So that is the third part of the body where is the belly. So they try to have to make money and they will to increase that. So they are in the third part of the belly. And the last part is called as the Sudras. Who is Sudras? The Sudras are the low class people, but it's not considered as a low class. They are considered to be at the fourth class of the people. No one is considered to be as a high class or low class. Everyone is dependent to each other. So these Sudra classes are little less intelligent. They are not have, they are mostly on the ignorant state. What they will do is they will do some work by serving these three classes. So they will not have any intelligence why they are working and what is the purpose and what the Veda says and what is this thing. They are not going to consider about it. So they are in the service classes. They are considered to be the last of the fourth classes. So this division is being done only according to the modes. See, Krishna says that it is based according to the modes and the nature of their mode. He says that their own nature, the bond with their own nature in accordance with the material modes. So how it is related to the material modes? Like first we have to see is like when you considered about like a Brahmana. So what about the Brahmana? Brahmana is in a highly intelligent class and they want to have to be more spiritually realized. So for more spiritually realized, we need to be more in the mode of goodness. So mode of goodness is the majority. So if you are not in the mode of the goodness, your Brahmana cannot able to improve his quality. It is not possible. So he has to improve his quality only in the mode of goodness. So his mode will be morely in the sattva stage. His mode is mostly in the sattva guna. So when you consider about a kshatriya should be in the mode of patience. She should not be in the mode of goodness. If he says be in the mode of goodness, what will happen to a kshatriya? Like when you be in the mode of goodness, what he will think? Like he will be reciting Vedas. Like when you come when someone is coming want to have to protect the country, he need to fight against for his kingdom. He cannot be in the mode of goodness. He need to be in the mode of patience. So he need to be more brave. Always need to be more enthusiastic that he has to have to protect the country. So that is about the kshatriya. So they be mostly in the mode of patience, but they have a little concept of mode of goodness, because if you see, kshatriyas are mostly kings. Like when you see in Srimad Bhagavatam, there is a lot of stories about great kings or like rishis, like might be Ambarish Maharaj, like Prithu Maharaj. They are all great people, but they are all rishis, but they are also very good in mode of goodness also. That not only in the mode of patience, they are all in the mode of goodness. They have given the right thing to even for the for their own people. They are given the righteous things, what they have to properly, they are following the religious principles. They have to give proper knowledge about Krishna consciousness. So they are very particular about it. It doesn't mean that they are always in the mode of patient, but the mode of patient is in the major category. But after, the mode of goodness will be there. So they cannot be completely in the mode of patient. But there are certain kshatriyas who are also being there in the mode of patient completely. Like you take example of Jarasandh. What happened to Jarasandh? Jarasandh is such a he's a king. He's a kshatriya, but he's completely in the mode of goodness, that he want to have to capture all the like complete kingdom, and he want to make every king to be their slaves. So Krishna only has to relieve them from their custody. So the thing is that Jarasandh misused this kshatriya quality, right? So he is just a kshatriya. He need to protect the citizens. He just want to hurt so many people because he is more powerful. He's thinking, I am more powerful, so I can do whatever I want. A kshatriya should not do that. So the kshatriya, if he is there in the little mode of goodness only, he will understand the shastra in a proper way, and he will know that what is right and what is wrong. So he cannot say that a kshatriya should be always in the mode of passion. So he needs to have little knowledge about the mode of goodness. And if you take about this Vaishyas, they are in the mostly in the mercantile class, but these people are always being engaged in economic development. Even though they are engaged in the economic development, they are the people who are always protecting all the animals and everything. Because if you consider, the cow protection is mostly being done by the Vaishyas. You see, Krishna is born as a kshatriya. You know, because Krishna was born in a jail, he was born as a son of Vasudev, but he is a kshatriya. But after that, he was brought up as a Vaishya, because he is brought up in Vrindavan. So Vrindavan is a Vaishya community, like all are Vaishyas. So what this is, they are always engaging in cows. So they are all be herding the cows, they are protecting the cows, they are protecting their village by like they are doing farming and all that. So this type of people are Vaishyas. But they are not so interested to go to Vedic knowledge and all that, because their real motive is that they have to make economic development. That is the majority of the Vaishyas. And then if you consider about the Sudras, Sudras are a very less intelligent classes. They never want to worry about anything. So whatever they are, we depend only on these three people. So if the work is given by the three people, they will work it. But they will work and they will live and they will die. That's it. They will never want to think about why these Vedas are given and all this, and why they want to produce money. If they give money, they will work. They will do such service and they will go. They are about the Sudra level. But when you consider about Sudras, they are the last class, right? And I told about they are in the body part, they are in the legs. So they are in the foot, legs, because they need to be very strong. For that, their legs should be so strong. They will be working in the field sometimes. Like they are also Sutra people also. They will work in the field for a long time. They will also do such hard work. Like they are in many they will work there in they're not like mercantile class, but they will work as a labor class. They will work and they will get money and they will do. So these are the four, but their modes, what their mode will be, they are mostly in the mode of ignorance. So they never be in the passion or something. Whatever they get, they will live and they will go. So this way, Krishna says that these are all not by birth. This is all by the quality, how they are being. So this, if their quality is improved, even if Sudrakana can become a Brahmana, like if they are able to have that ability, that they will not come under the class. Even though if they born as a Sudra, they can also come to that way. If they have the proper way, if they are connected to the Lord through Krishna consciousness or conscious of Krishna, they can also go to the higher level. So this is about the four categories of this Varna Ashrama. So Varna is this force, but what is about the ashrama? What this ashrama is about, all this, like whether you are a brahmachari or a grahastha or you vanaprastha or a sannyasi, that is the ashrama which they will follow. Ashrama is also that they are like the four categories. There are four types. They are like whether you want to be in, want to have to live as a brahmachari, and you can also live like that, or whether you want to have to marry, or if you have to do that, that is grahastha ashrama. And when you want to have to go out for the forest and you have to serve the God, that is vanaprastha. And you have to be renounced, that you have to give up everything and you have to go to the stage is called renunciation. They will take up a sannyas. So this is the ashrama which is it. But Krishna, now he is going to discuss about this three modes, how it was thus working, like how in this being working on this three modes. So he is going to explain about this qualities of each and every varnas. Like he is going to explain about what are the quality of a brahmana, what is the quality of a vaishya, what is the quality of a kshatriya, and what is the quality of the vaishya. And he is going to come to the point. So why I was explaining about this, I will tell you after that. So first he has to know about it. But in the previous fourth chapter itself, Krishna was saying about these four varnas, but he is not described so deeply about what is mean by a kshatriya and what is mean by a brahmana and what is that. Not so deep. It's not so deep inside the philosophy. There is a reason, you know why? Because at that time, Arjuna was in a first stage, like he was just being more under lamentation, and he was knowing about this sastra, and he was asking about so many questions. What is yoga? What is karma yoga? What is jnana yoga? And all these questions were there. And if he started explaining about that, he will not be in that stage to understand it. So he needs little advancement. So when he go after bhakti yoga, after devotional service, after surrenderment, then their level will increase. So after that, it is possible for him to give the detailed description about what about all these things. So here he says about these three modes on the different ashramas. So I think so that you have an idea about who is a brahmana, who is a kshatriya, and who is a sudra and a vaishya. So we will go to the next sloka where I will give you the what is the quality of a brahmana. So I will read the sloka. I'll just share that screen with you. I can do. And then we will discuss about the both slokas. Next one. Savodamastapasaucham.
Samodamastapasaucham.
Shanti Arjavam Yevacha.
Shanti Arjavam Yevacha.
Jnanam Vijnanam Ashikyam.
Jnanam Vijnanam Ashikyam.
Brahma karma swabhavajam.
Brahma karma swabhavajam.
Okay. The synonym sama means peacefulness.
Sama is peacefulness.
Dhamma, self-control.
Dhamma, self-control.
Tapa, austerity.
Tapa, austerity.
Saucham, purity.
Saucham, purity.
Shanti, tolerance.
Shanti, tolerance.
Arjavam, honesty.
Arjavam, honesty.
Yeva, certainly.
Yeva, certainly.
Cha, and.
Cha, and.
Jnanam, knowledge.
Jnanam, knowledge.
Vijnanam, wisdom.
Vijnanam, wisdom.
Astikyam, religiousness.
Astikam religiousness.
Brahma of a Brahmana.
Brahma of a Brahmana.
Karma, duty.
Karma, duty.
Swabhajam, born of his own nature. Peacefulness, self-control, austerity, purity, tolerance, honesty, knowledge, wisdom, and religiousness. These are the natural qualities by which the Brahmanas work. Excuse me. Hare Krishna. So then, now we have discussed about, Krishna was discussing about these four classes of people. Now he is going to give the detailed description of what is the quality of a Brahmana. So the first thing is giving about the quality of the Brahmana. So what we mean by a Brahmana? Brahmana means there's a stage of who is a Brahman. So that is called as a Brahmana. So he says that what are the quality a Brahmana must have? So he starts with Sama. Samaha means peacefulness, calm. So he starts with the mind. So what is peacefulness? Where you will get the peace? Peace will start only from the mind, right? So the mind is the first stage. So when you are not able to control your mind, it is not possible for you to go further. So even if a Brahmana, they have to control their mind because they have to be involved mostly on the Brahman. So they have to meditate on the Brahman. They have to serve on the Brahman. So they have to think like when they are reciting the Veda, Vedic mantras, they should be very, very particular and they should be use their they have to use their tongue and you have to pronounce it properly. If they pronounce it improperly, then the meaning will change. So they have to be very particular about calming the mind. So they should not get agitated or anything. So that whatever they said, it will become, it is not proper. It becomes improper. So the first thing which Krishna says is Samaha. So first he starts with the mind. Then only he goes to that next to the senses. So first, if the mind is controlled only, the next to the senses will be controlled. So first he starts with the mind. So he says that Samaha. So that is one of the quality of the Brahmana. He says that Samaha, peacefulness. And then next is Dhamas. Dhamaha means self-control. The self-control will come only when you control the senses. So the control of senses can become only if you control your mind, then the next step is easy for you to control the senses. So they have to be controlled by the senses. So they cannot do whatever they want. So they, because it's a Brahmana, they have to be restricted to certain things. So they cannot go out like other people, like other like what you tell, a Brahmana should have to use whatever he get, what is the nature of a Brahmana is like, you should not expect anything at all. So if he didn't even have money or even wealth or even food, he needs to have to control his senses. He cannot say that, oh my God, like if I didn't get it, he cannot feel bad or lament or anything. They have to control it. Yes, if they didn't get anything, they have to control their senses. So this from the mind, they have to go for the senses. They need to be get to be controlled. So the Samaha, Dhamas, and the Tapas, austerity. So they should be very, they have to fast on the certain days and they should not eat food which is more rajoguna and all these things. So they should have to maintain austerity. So austerity is like that. They will do a lot of fastings on Ekadeshis and so many days. So they will do it so that your mind will be controlled and their senses will be controlled. If they eat more and all these things, what will happen? Then it is not possible for them to control. So they will do something. What is the quality? They will lose their quality. The quality will be lose soon. So the austerity is very, very important for a Brahmana. So they have to strictly follow the regulations of when they have to do the fastings and all these things. And they have to eat only this, very sattvic, pure sattvic food. Such things are all very important for that. So this austerity is more important. Next is about purity. He says that chaucham. Chaucham is the purity. The purity is in the both way. That is internal and external purity. So wait, I'll go further. So he says about purity, right? So what is about the purity? So he says about purity is the two ways, that is internal and external. So both the purity you need. So what do you mean by internal purity and external purity? So external purity is they need to be very clean. So they need to have to take bath very early in the morning. In the case that I told about austerity, right? Austerities is that they will wake up very early in the morning and they have to do all their rituals and everything properly. So they cannot recite the Vedic mantras at the mid of the morning or like the mid of the afternoon or something like that. They have to recite their Vedas at the right time. So if you see, like the Samaveda, it should be recited at the Brahma Muhurta. So that was there. It is to be considered that Samaveda should be always recited in the Brahma Muhurta. That is even in Vaikuntha. When you see all the Nityasuris and all the Muktatmas, they are all been standing there, and everyone will be reciting the Vedic mantras. They will be reciting the Samaveda in the morning. So they have to follow that. So these things is like they have to follow that austerity and purity. So the purity should be there. The purity is they should be very clean. So they have to take bath very early in the morning so that the purity should be there. That is external purity. What about internal purity? Internal purity is that they don't have any more desires. They have to be free from anarthas. These are all internal purities. So internal purities is very important, because if they have more anarthas and everything in their heart, they cannot able to concentrate more on the spiritual progress. That is not possible for them. So that anarthas should not be there. They should not be envious. They should not have. So all the anarthas should be completely removed. So they not be more desire, like they don't have such desire at all in their life. So if they have desire also, that should be fulfilled by satisfying the Lord. That should not have more than that desires. When you take example of like when you take the story of Sudama Vipra is in like he was in the poverty stage, right? Like he's a Daritra stage. Like it is below the poverty stage. He just suffered so much, but he never expected and not have any desire at all. He says that I want to serve Krishna, but he is not only a Brahmana, he is a pure devotee of the Lord. So a Brahmana is always, Prabhupada says that a Brahmana is the first stage, like he's in the pure goodness, but a Vaishnava is more than a Brahmana. You know, because when they are connected to Krishna and when they surrender to Krishna, when they do devotional service to Krishna, a Brahmana will come to the other like elevated stage to become a Vaishnava. So in the first, if you say that, for example, if you take that in Bhagavad Gita, like Krishna was saying that in second chapter. His second chapter, he was saying, Asochyan Anvasochasam Prajnavadanta Badati Katashum Atasashum Sa Nanu Shochanti Panditaka. He says that you are a Pandita. So he says that a Pandita. Pandita is a self explanation. It is a general qualification that you are a Pandita. Pandita is also a Brahmana. He also says that your Pandita means he's a learned person who is learned. But in India and all, we'll say that he is a Pandita. Pandita only. As a Brahmana also, they will say as a Pandita. So Pandita is a learned person, but they will not come to the stage of a Vaishnava. When they are understanding Krishna and they surrender to Krishna, then they serve Krishna, then only they will come from the Brahmana stage to a Vaishnava stage. They are more superior than a Brahmana. So a Vaishnava is already have the quality of a Brahmana. Even though he is born in the Sudra family, he is considered to be as a Brahmana. So that is considered as a purity. So the purity is very important for a Brahmana, both internal purity and as well as external purity. The next most important thing is the tolerance. So the tolerance level should be very high for a Brahmana. So he should not get agitated for anything. So the tolerance is like when you see, there are so many circumstances in which the Brahmana will face, because they are mostly, you see, that Brahmanas will not have any answers to have the wealth, or they have to have more comforts in their life and everything. So sometimes they will be happy, sometimes they will have more money, sometimes they don't have money. So they have to be very tolerant, like whatever may be the situation, because they have the family. It's not that Brahmanas always be Brahmacharis. They also have Grihasthas, so they also have family. You can say the example of Sudama Vipra. He's a Brahmana, but he's a Grihastha, right? So he was just suffering so much in the life. And his wife was saying that we have children, we need to take care of them. Please go to Krishna. Krishna is already king, he is a friend. You can ask him for anything. But like Sudama has no intensity to go to Krishna and ask for anything. Correct? He just felt like, no, I don't want to have to go for it. He doesn't have any desire. He just want to have to serve only the only the Lord. He never wants to have to expect anything from the Lord. He is not having even intention to ask, Krishna, I am there in this situation. Will you please help me? No, he don't have that. But even though he felt, because he is very tolerable, because as a Brahmana, he has that quality. He is born as a Brahmana. He's a Vipra. Vipra means Brahmana. He is a Vipra. He is a Brahmana. But he has that quality of tolerance. He has more tolerance in that. The tolerance level is very high in that. But if you take example of Ashwatthama. Ashwatthama is also a Brahmana. He's a Brahmana because he is Drona's son, right? But he don't have the tolerance, right? He was just being associated with Duryodhana and he was just killed all the innocent children of Draupadi, the high sons of Draupadi, right? And he was just, he is considered to be not as a Brahmana at all, he's a Brahma Bandhu. Because as a Brahmana, he's lost the quality. He has to be tolerant, he has to be truthful, all the quality he has lost. Because even though he has just born from such a family and he has just got the knowledge from his father, but he has just behaved like that by killing these innocent children. So that is an example of non-tolerance, even as he was born. So Krishna says that not he has born from the bond, he has born from the family. He has to have the quality. The quality is very important. The guna is very important. They have to maintain it. So that is about the tolerance. And then next is about the honesty. Honesty is none other than truthfulness. They should be very truthful. They should not, their satyam is a very important thing for a Brahmana. They should not speak lies because in their tongue, they are reciting Vedas, right? So when they are reciting Vedas, when they speak something which is lie, how it is possible that how it will work out? It is really, it become bogus. Correct. So they should be very truthful whatever they does. If they have, if they are there in the situation, they will accept it. They will not tell anything lie and they want to get something. No, they will not do that. That is not a that is not a mentality of a Brahmana because they know what is right and what is wrong because they know about the dharmic religious principles. So they have to follow for that. So they should, the first principle which they want to follow is the truth, the honesty. I'll tell you one example in the Chandogya Upanishad. Chandogya Upanishad, like in the Chandogya Upanishad, described that there was a boy. That boy will come and approach a guru, and the guru will ask the boy, "My dear," like he say that, "My dear guru, I really want to have to get the knowledge. So will you please help me to get that knowledge?" So that guru will ask me, "What is your what is your qualification? Where you are born? Who is your father?" All these questions he will ask. That guru will ask. So the boy will say "Who is your father? Which is your family name? Whether you are come from a Brahmana or a Kshatriya?" He says, "Ask this question." That boy didn't understand anything. So he says that, "I don't know anything. I will go and ask my mother." So what he says that he'll just go there and he want to go and ask my mother, "My dear mother, tell me who is my father." Because he is asking that, "Where I born, what is my family name?" His mother says that, "I don't know who is your father. I'm not knowing about it, who is your father." So what this boy will say is that boy will come and tell to the guru, "My dear guru, I don't know. Because my mother says that he doesn't know who is my father. So I don't know which family name I belong." So he just told the truth. So the guru will accept it because the first quality for a Brahmana is the truth because he speaks satyam. He speaks the truth. So he says that you already spoke the truth. That means you already got the quality of a Brahmana. So you become a Brahmana. You are a Brahmana. So I will teach you the Vedic rituals and Vedic principles. So the thing is that the honesty is a very important quality of a Brahmana. So it is not like that a Brahmana is like, "I have born in a Brahmana family, so I can do whatever. I have lot of intelligence so that I can use it for my sense gratification. So I can speak anything, I can do anything." No, it is not the quality. The quality is that first most important is honesty. They should be very, very truthful. So that is the quality of a Brahmana. And the next thing is about knowledge and wisdom. That is jnana and vijnana. Jnana is a theoretical knowledge. Vijnana is a practical knowledge. So jnana means like what you know, like through Vedas. They will be reciting Vedic mantras and everything. So they got the knowledge from their proper guru, right? They will get that Vedic mantras. But without realization about what is that, what it says in that Vedas, that you have to have a knowledge of vijnana. Vijnana means it is one step more than jnana. Jnana is understanding and that's just reciting the theoretically. But vijnana is the thing which you are like saying what is right and what is wrong. So that is a practical knowledge which they have. So they have to have both. So Brahmana has to have the both, because they have to know what is the theoretical knowledge, and as well as, because they have to preach, right? They have to give that knowledge to other people. So they have to know both. So they just know a Vedic Granth and they will just recite that to other, their Shishyas, that their disciples. Then what will happen? Like, they also will read the same thing. But they have to be in the realization stage to give them the right thing, which is right and wrong, what is being pronounced in the Vedas, what is given in that. So they have to have both Jnana and Vijnana. So both is knowledge and the wisdom. So they have to be well versed in both of that. So this is explained. And then is religiousness. So religiousness is nothing but faith. They should have more firm faith. So whatever they have. So that is, firm faith is very important. So without faith, they cannot able to understand anything. So the first and foremost thing is, like, they also have to have faith. Without faith, they are just knowing the Vedas, and they are reading the scriptures, and they are reciting the slokas. Then how it is possible for them to give it to other people? So it is not possible. So the thing is, first, they should be very religious. So they have to have faith. Religious means what? Faith on God. They have to have faith on it. Just like that, like a machine, if they have read it and they are going to give it to other people, it is not going to be useful for them. So a Brahmana is in such a stage. So only Krishna is given in such high position for them, because they are the one who have the knowledge of Brahman. So they have to give the knowledge of Brahman to others. Is that will give everything to us. See, if you say, like, if they want to do yajna, that we need a Brahman. Right? A Brahman has to know, because they know how to recite the Vedas, in where, in which Veda it will come, in which Veda they have to recite this, and all that the Brahman only knows it. So you want to get the rain, if a Sudra, like their Vaishya are expecting a rain, so I want to get the rain, they have to depend on a Brahmana. So a Brahmana has to be there, that a Brahmana has to do that yajna, as Krishna says, and Annad Bhavati Utani. Pragyanya Anna Sambhavaga, he says that in the third chapter, Krishna says that. So yajna is a way for that getting rain. Through that rain only we will get the Anna, we will get the food grains. So for that, we need a proper person to have to do the yajnas. So if they have to do the yajnas and everything, all that thing, a Brahmana should be highly qualified. So they have to be very religious. The most thing is they have to have faith. If they didn't have the faith, and if they recite the Vedas or in the yajnas, then the rain will not come. So they're just, hey, I studied the Veda, so I'm just reciting. No, the rain will not come. So that is the most important thing, that they are to be very religious. So these are the nature qualities by which the Brahmanas work. He says that. And it is also explained in Srimad Bhagavatam by Prahlad Maharaj in the seventh canto. It might be in the seventh canto. He says that, seventh canto in the ninth chapter, he says that, विप्राद्विषद्गुणायुधात् अरविन्दनाभा पथारविन्दमुखात् स्ववचं वरिष्ठम्. He says that मन्ये तत्तर्पितो मनवच्चे हिरातार्थ प्राणं पुनाति शकुलं नतूत भूम्यः. He says that विप्रात् द्विषद्गुणायुधात् अरविन्दनाभा द्विषद्. Like he says that, who is a Vipra? Vipra means is a Brahmana. What is the quality of the Brahmana is Divishat Guna Yudata. Divishat Guna means he has to have 12 qualifications. You want to become a Brahmana. He says that if you don't have the 12 qualification, even though if he has the 12 qualification, Yudata Aravinda Nava Padharavinda. He says that if he is not surrendered to the lotus feet, like lotus eyes of the Lord, the Padaravinda. Padaravinda means the lotus feet of the Lord. If he is not ready to surrender to the lotus feet of the Lord, Vimukkat Svapacham Varishtam. He says that a dog eater is better than he, if he is a devotee. If a dog eater or a Shandala is a devotee, he is better than that Brahmana. Even though if he has the 12 qualification, in Brahma Sastra, it says that a Brahmana should have this 12 qualification. You know, what are this qualification? What we discussed about it. Here Krishna also say the same qualification, but he says about this qualification. What are the qualification? He says this, like I'll tell that it was there. He say that, The 12 qualifications are, you should be religious, truthful, controlling the senses, controlling the eyes and non-envious, very intelligent, very tolerant, engage in sacrifice, charitable, powerful memory, learned scholar, and he must endure with vows. These are the 12 qualifications which he has to have. It also says in Madhya Leela, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also discussed that with Sanatan Goswami. It is in Antya Leela and in Madhya Leela also. Madhya Leela, it was on 20th Parpat. It says that Prabhupada says that Samo Dabastavakka Saucham Shante Arjava Vivakyaha Jnana Vijnana Santoshaha Satyatik Vidishad Gunayaha. He said that Divishad Gunayaha. These are the 12 qualifications. Sama, which we discussed. Tapas, Damas is also tapas, saucha, shanti, ajava, vivekyaya, jaya, vijnana, santoshatya, divichat gunayaha. He says that about these are the 12 qualifications need for the Brahmana. That is mental equilibrium, sense control, austerity, cleanliness, tolerance, simplicity, detachment, and theoretical and practical knowledge, satisfaction, truthfulness, and the firm faith. So these are the qualifications for the Brahmana. So here we are saying that, this is the quality of a Brahmana. So if I get this quality, can I become a Brahmana? Yes, you can become a Brahmana. You are in that class. But if you are not fit for, like if you are being in this classes is not very important. Like whatever you does, you have to do it for the satisfaction of the Lord, for the pleasure of the Lord. That is very important. You might be in any other classes, it might be. If you are not doing it for Krishna, if it is not for satisfaction of the Lord, then whatever you does is useless. You might be in any class, because if you are doing it for the satisfaction of the Krishna, you will never fall in this category at all. You are not going to be a Brahmana, Kshatriya, you are become a Vaishya. You become a pure Vaishnava. You will become a pure devotee of the Lord. So the devotee of the Lord will not fall in any one of the category. Even he will not fall in the form of the Brahman category, because he is already being qualified more than a Brahmana. He already got the quality of a Brahmana. So he is just being, because these are the things a Vaishnava will have it, right? Like I told about the Sudama Vipra. What Sudama Vipra was there? Sudama Vipra is a Brahmana, but he is not considered him as a Brahmana. He is a pure devotee, because he is not expecting anything, but everything is for the satisfaction of the Lord. He is always thinking about the Lord only. He never thought it, even though Krishna is gave everything. He gave us such a wonderful palace and everything, but he is not got attracted to anything. He says that he is always doing the same. Like what he was doing, he was just doing Namajava. He was just doing offering and puja, and he was always meditating on the Lord. He never thought about what wealth he got and how he become a very wealthy Brahmana. He never thought about it, because he is a pure devotee. He was a pure devotee. And the next thing is, if you take an example of Saint Tukaram, Saint Tukaram is such a pure devotee. Like he was always be singing the glories of Lord Panduranga. He will always sings about Vittala, 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 Vittala. He never stop at the time. Whatever he does, he just think about only Vittala, only Panduranga. He never thought about anything. So what happened? Like he just been detached, even though he is in a Grahastha life. He was a Grahastha. He was having children. He was there doing, but he never got attached to anything. That time Shivaji was ruling. The Shivaji Maharaj, he just came and he just met Tukaram, Saint Tukaram, and he was just really got astonished to see such a pure devotee. He just asked, "My dear Saint Tukaram Maharaj, can you please accept me? Because I'm ready to give up my kingdom and I come behind you as a disciple." Tukaram says, "No, you're good. I can accept you as a disciple, but not now. You are a Kshatriya. There is a duty for you. You have to do it. And you have to perform that." So a Brahmana is knowing, right? He is a Brahmana and he is not a Brahmana. He is a pure devotee. He is more than a Brahmana. He has got the quality of a Brahmana. He knows what is right and what is wrong. So he says that, yes, you are a Kshatriya. You have the duty. You have to perform your duty. That is your first thing. You have to make it. So don't come behind me. There is a time you can come. But you have the responsibility as a Kshatriya to take care of your kingdom. So please take care of that first and then come to me. So that is the qualification of a devotee, right? The devotee will have that qualities because it's already they become a Brahmana. They know or they have all these qualities what the Brahmana has. So Krishna is explaining about other classes of people also, like he was explaining about Kshatriya and the Sudra, which is already 7:52. So I will stop here. Thank you, everyone. If you have any questions or realizations or anything, you can share any mistakes or anything. And I really forgive everyone, please, if there is any mistakes. Okay, thank you. Jai Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Anta Kodi Vaishnava Vrinda ki jai.
Hare Krishna Mataji.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji.
Mataji, thank you so much. This is a very nice class. One comment that I remember, Srila Prabhupada said that for devotees, there is no material qualification needed. Okay. And the 12 qualities that you mentioned, so which starts with honesty, sincerity, and so on. Okay. So I believe as sadhakas continue the devotional service or you following all four regulative principles,
correct,
by doing that process, devotee will eventually get or build those qualities,
correct,
even though he doesn't or she doesn't have today.
Yes, correct.
Yeah, that's what I would like to share.
Yes, Prabhuji. Thank you, Prabhuji. Correct. Yes, because he is already being qualified, because if you are being following all the regulative principles, he will get the quality of that, what all the Brahmana has. So that is the case, like in our ISKCON, we are having the second initiation as a Brahminical initiation, right? Like if you have a Brahminical initiation, that means we are come to that level, like to be a Brahmana. So you have all these qualities. So when you are developing that qualities, so that you are naturally become a Brahmana, because you are already a Vaishnava who are been following all strict regulative principles. That means you are developing that quality. That is correct. Yes, Prabhuji. Thank you. Thank you for that. Anyone?
Hare Krishna Mataji, very nice class, very well researched. Thank you so much. I had a question about, so I think one of the things that you mentioned is the quality of a Brahman is he's religious. Mm-hmm. And then you are talking distinctly about faith. Mm-hmm. So he should have firm faith. So what exactly, in what context are you using the word religious here?
Here religious is like, there are people who are religious, people will go to temple, they will do everything. That is also considered to be as religious, because they are doing for pious things or all that. But then there is no need that they have 100% faith and everything. So they will go for some material benefits or something they have, and they will have, okay, this God will give, otherwise we have to go like that. But here as a Brahmana, they are religious, like what here mean as religious is that the firm faith. I read once in Prabhupada purport, or I heard that for Prabhupada has given the meaning as religious is the faith in God. That is a meaning for religious. So I really felt like that is the one which here also it mentioned.
That's right. But you used to, so you define faith and religion as two distinct qualities. That's why I was just trying to understand in what context you were using. Or you mentioned, right, faith also in one of the categories.
Religious means faith. Yeah, might be.
I'm just, and this is my assumption, mm-hmm, that when it says religious, it could be related to rituals, mm, that you follow certain rituals, even though you may not have faith, but still you follow,
correct,
the externals of certain things.
Right.
That could be it, but just this is my assumption.
Yeah, and one of the qualities of a Brahmana, it says wisdom and religiousness also, it says, right? Specifically.
Yes, Mataji. Yes, Mataji. Correct. Right.
So I have a very basic question. Maybe my understanding is wrong, because I just started this, my steps towards with Lord Krishna and Bhagavad Gita, everything recently. So my question is, like, we all act according to the destination, right? As the God decides, as we believe in the God and faith. So this agitation, emotions, all the 12 qualities, those are sometimes not in our control, right? The situation is created by the God and we act accordingly, like emotions mainly. And the agitation or reactions come from these emotions. And the like now, example, take COVID and Corona. We cannot travel to India or some other place. And our parents are there or some families there, kind of. So we have to react, right? Some or the other day we react. So how can we proceed in this kind of situations? Because the situation is given by God and the emotions are created by God and we are completely moving according to him, right?
Correct. Yeah, we are, like means like we are indirectly we are developing that quality because we are tolerant, correct? We are tolerating it. So we cannot go against it. But we are developing that quality of tolerance. So this never comes like whatever situation, like we cannot get it as soon as like that, because we have taken millions of births and where we were being in different bodies, where we have different modes in which we are lived, and that modes will all be there in our subtle mind. So we cannot able to get that situation very easily. Like we cannot go to that level of to become a brahmana or such things. So that needs a practice. Like when you are being devoted to the Lord and when you are believing the faith, these are all the simple baby steps which we take. So when you take this type of baby steps in which that automatically that quality will also get to be developed in your heart. So we will get it. We cannot see that because we have that quality already, but it might be like we are not developed that so much. Yeah, that has not been there with that. So when we are able to associate it with good people and we are able to see everything, then we will know that, yes, we are associating with devotees and all that, that we will be able to develop. If you're a normal person also, they have to develop that. So that is practical when they feel it. Okay, fine. But we are going against something. Might be they believe God or they don't believe God. That is a different matter. That is not a thing. But they will go according to it because we have to go. We cannot go anything against it. So what we will do is, it's better I have to tolerate. We have to go according to that. So this quality indirectly will come to you. When you are keep on practicing it, when you are trying to accept it, then you will get this type of qualities within yourself. That is my answer. If anyone have any other question, they can share. That's my answer, Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. This is Malati Priya, Mataji.
Yes, Mataji.
Excellent class, Mataji. I have a basic question. And now Krishna is considered a Kshatriya, right?
Correct.
But Krishna is the highest Brahmin also, right? I know Krishna can be anything, but generally when you speak about Krishna, is he a Brahmin or a Kshatriya?
Yeah, he's all right. He's transcendental, right? He will not be affected by anything. But I just gave this as an example. He's like he's born as a Kshatriya, then he's he was being brought up as a Vaishya. Krishna, like Prabhupada also says that in the purport, in the fourth chapter, the same thing in the purport, he says that, you know. Krishna is transcendental to this system of four divisions of human society. A person in Krishna consciousness is also transcendental to all divisions of human society, whether we consider the division of community or nation or species. So he is not been affected by anything. So he is already, he cannot come under this any class at all. He is not considered to be a Kshatriya, he is not considered to be a Sutra, he is not considered to be anything. He is transcendental. So whatever he related, that becomes transcendental. So if a devotee, even though if he is born in that any classes where he born, when he is connected to Krishna, he will not connect, he becomes transcendental. Even though if he is a Sudra, he is also transcendental because he is connected to Krishna. So Krishna is not affected that as well as the devotee is also not affected. So that was there. This is explained in the fourth chapter, in the 13th sloka, the purport, Prabhupada was explaining about this.
Yes, Madhi. And like, but you said, the Brahmana's qualities, you know, they have different qualities, but still if they don't accept Krishna as the supreme, they are, you know, their all knowledge is useless. That can be learned from the Krishna book, Brahmana Patnis, you know, they were more merciful and they were readily accepted Krishna and Balaram and gave them the boga, whereas the Brahmins will refuse the boga to even the Lord.
Yes, Mataji, correct.
So that's an example of, even though if you're educated and you have all the qualities, but if you don't recognize Krishna or serve him when there's no point.
Correct.
Thank you.
Yes, Mati.
Although Krishna was transcendental to all the Varnas, when he was here, he did follow all the traditional regulative principles, correct? I mean,
yes.
Getting up early in the morning, yeah. You know, doing all the traditional, you know, he followed all the principles. Yeah.
So he shows
as an example
that how a Kshatriya should be, how a Brahmana should be, how
could
a Grihastha should be. Yes, and Narada Muni also asked this question. So when he was just visiting the Lord in the Dwaraka in the palace, he was asking why you are acting like, because he just when a great saint was entering into the in his palace, what you have to do? Like, we have to do all Achamana and everything. We have to take care of him. So he was asking, why are you doing? You are a Supreme Lord. Why you want to do that? The Lord says that it is a duty of a Grihastha to have to do that. So he's just teaching us the example that how we need to be. That is it. Yes, Mataji. Yes,
and Mataji, one more thing. Shamika Rishi's son is a Brahmana, you know. But Shringi, right? His name, yeah. Correct. So, but obviously he was not a Brahmana because he got so mad at Parikshit Maharaj, right? He lost his control
he's lost his tolerance, right? Like he becomes agitated, right? Because of that, yes. Even his father will tell, right?
Go to the forest and learn control and austerity or something.
Correct.
Yeah, Maltipriya, his act is considered the first downfall of the Brahmanas in Kali Yuga, you know.
Oh, is it right? Okay.
Chinggis, yeah.
All right. That's my pleasure. I think so. Then, it is already 8:30. Thank you so much.
Madhi, I think Ganapati Govind had some comment to make. I think.
Yes, Mataji. Yeah, please.
No, Madhi, I didn't had any comment, but I think I just wanted to say one thing about Brahman and Kshatriya. Actually, in the fourth chapter, if you see the theme. First, Krishna says, Imam Vivaspati Yogam Proktavahan Aham Abhyayam. Basically, he says, I gave this knowledge to the sun god. So giving knowledge is the role of a Brahmin. So he actually is acting as a Brahmin by giving knowledge. And this knowledge comes down in parampara and through which the Raj Rishis administer. But again, in 4.7, he also says, Vinashaya cha Dushkritam is one of the functions that he performs when he descends. So that is the role of a Kshatriya. Vinashaya cha Dushkritam. So he actually acts both as a Brahmin and as a Kshatriya. He gives the knowledge and when necessary he picks up weapons and he kills also.
Right. So a lot of realization we can get from Bhagavad Gita. You know, each and every akshara, each and every word, there is a meaning. Acharyas has given so many description about when you just get the commentary from different acharyas, they have a different thing. Like even in Gita Bhashya also, it is from Ramanuja Acharya also, there is so many things, but it is very difficult for us to understand. Because of Prabhupada, we are able to understand this much. It is not easy to understand Bhagavad Gita like that. It is not an easy, it's an Upanishad. It's a Gita Upanishad. Upanishad is not easy to understand. It needs a lot of knowledge, deep insight, philosophical knowledge to understand Bhagavad Gita. But because of Srila Prabhupada's mercy, we are able to understand to this level. Otherwise, we don't know whether we can be able to get it. All glories to Srila Prabhupada.
I never thought about that. Very nice realization, yeah.
Anyone have anything or we can end now?
Thank you so much. Hare Krishna.